I'm Dr. Tara Egan from Dr. Tara Egan LLC, and today we're going to talk about how to determine whether or not your kids have balance when it comes to using technology and social media. So on this side of the diagram, I want to talk about what a healthy balance looks like. So if we look at this circle, and I like to call it pi, and we consider it to be a 24-hour period of time, one day, and we break it into a balanced day, I want to show you what we're going to see. So first of all, over a 24-hour day, we would want our kids to have at least a third of that time actually asleep. So not in their room, not just in the dark, but actually sleeping. And for some kids, they need more than that. They need 8, 9, 10 hours of sleep. So it's important to recognize that that should be something that we protect whenever possible. So a third of this graph consists of sleep, that's here in the green. And then about that same amount of time, we're going to expect to see school. So most kids, and I know that with online learning, and some kids are doing it through like homeschooling options and things like that. So I know not every child is spending a full 7 or 8 hours at school or doing schoolwork, but some kids, especially high schoolers, are spending even more time than that because they also have homework in addition to class time. So I'm just going to say for the purposes today that a third of the kids' day is spent at school. Now I realize that at school, they have the opportunity to use technology. And most of the time it's encouraged, of course, that kids use technology time that's related to their school activities. So it might be their class is working on a project. It might be that they're doing research. They're using a certain program to complete math problems or to write their essays, things like that. So I don't really include academic technology usage in our overall understanding of technology usage, okay? Because I would consider that to be sort of mandatory appropriate usage of technology. And then from here, the remainder of the day, which is the final third of the day, we would expect that kids are engaging in a series of activities. So some of the things that I noted here would be technology time that's just fun and for entertainment. And this can include TV time, video game time, social media, iPad time, whatever, however our kids interpret technology time. We also have family time. So family time can consist of having meals together. It can overlap with one of the other sections here that I called chores and routines. It might be, together we walk the dog, or a child goes on an errand with a parent to go grocery shopping. And those are things they're doing both to connect with the family members as well as be a productive person in the household. So we have family time, we have chores and routine, and then there's also a portion in here in which there is extracurricular activity time / real life friend time. So whenever our kids do extracurricular activities, oftentimes they do them with peers, not always. Some kids do solitary activities, and that's completely fine. But we're talking about things like playing a team sport, being in a play, playing golf with some friends, out, playing basketball in the neighborhood, whatever it is, they're doing something with their friends. I have a client I'm currently working with where basically every day she and a friend in the neighborhood roller skate around. So those are things where kids are doing something that interests them outside of technology. And sometimes it's in a formal way, like playing on a team. Sometimes it's less formal, like the girl who roller skates around the neighborhood. But the opportunity is there for kids to spend some time connecting with real life peers, not just people on the internet or not just through a screen, like if they're playing a video game together, things like that. And I realized that during a busy school week, having time every day with a real life friend might not be possible. They might have a lot of homework. They might have some family obligations. They might be extra tired and need more sleep, and that's fine. But if we're kind of trying to look at a general healthy schedule for kids, we're seeing that technology time is really just taking up a small piece of the pie because there's so much more activity related to sleep, school, some family time, some extracurricular or friend time, some chores and routines. Now, chores and routines I count as taking a shower, picking out their clothes for the next day, getting their backpack arranged, and maybe more formal chores, like they need to take out the trash or do the dishes or walk the dog. But there should be some place in a kid's day where they're contributing to the family life and to the home that they live in. So it might just be a small section. It might be that they spend 20 minutes tidying up the kitchen after dinner, or you've asked them to clean up their room or put some laundry in and out of the washing machine. It doesn't have to be like where to be a healthy kid, your kid has to spend 1 hour or 45 minutes. It really has to do more about them just contributing to the household in a general sense. Okay. So this side, I would consider a relatively balanced kid. Okay. Because they're doing all of these things. They have an appropriate amount of sleep, appropriate amount of school, some friend time, some family time, some chores and routines. And then what's left over is fun, relaxed technology time. If they get these things done or they take a break during the day and they really enjoy looking at some things online or connecting with a friend playing a video game, it makes sense because it's in the balance of their life. And for older kids, sometimes in here, they might have an after-school job. And so there needs to be some time allotted for that too. Now I want to show you what I typically see when I work with kids. Now, a lot of times when parents call me, one of the primary referral questions they have, or concerns they have, is how out of balance their kid is when it comes to technology. They say their child is struggling to come to meals. They've dropped a lot of their extracurricular activities. They maybe have a poor attitude when it comes to separating from technology. When it's time to go to bed, maybe homework isn't completed. Maybe when parents look at their phone and they look at the screen time usage, they're seeing that their kids are on things like YouTube or social media apps while they're at school throughout the school day. They might see that their kids, instead of interacting with their peers at lunchtime, are sitting there watching a TV show with their phone during the lunch hour, and they're just not seeing balance. So in this pie, I see that a smaller percentage is allotted to sleep. So this is less than a quarter. So this might mean, let's say, 5 hours. The child is only getting 5 hours of actual sleeping time uninterrupted by technology. They might have just slightly more than a quarter of time for school, because we know that there's some mandatory time for them to be in school, but some of that time might be taken up with technology time that is not school-based. Like I said, during the lunch hour, or they're always kind of sneaking looks at social media, or they're switching over from an academic task to look at YouTube. The percentage of time that is dedicated to technology, and once again, social media, video games, browsing YouTube, looking at, you know, Safari, or just getting online access. Now, in this situation, when I look at kids' screen time, they might have upwards of 6, 8, sometimes even close to 14 hours a day in which they're actively using apps that are non-academic based. So they might be watching movies on their phone. A lot of times it's YouTube. A lot of times it's Snapchat and Instagram and TikTok. TikTok, of course, as parents we know, is a huge time suck because it is so interesting and entertaining. And there's a lot of my clients who are not posting anything on TikTok, but they scroll from one to another, and they can do it for hours. In this one, they have a tiny portion towards family time, and that's probably because mom and dad are just talking to them, and maybe that time might just even be consist of nagging because they're not doing their schoolwork and they're always on technology and they don't want to come to dinner. Maybe a kid in the neighborhood comes and knocks on the door and asks them to play, and they're like, nah, I'm playing a Roblox game. I'll catch you later. You know, maybe they're less interested in engaging in some of the activities they've done in the past, like playing on the soccer team or, learning piano or whatever it is that they were initially interested in. They've dropped off in their willingness to dedicate time to that. And then I have extremely small sliver here for chores and routine. And really, in these situations, it can be kind of a fight to get kids to take a shower, separate from technology to, you know, come feed the dog, and just engage in kind of the type of life
like the rhythm of the household that we typically see, you know, where kids are getting their school backpack ready, or they're trying to find where, you know, their favorite sneakers are. And so it's not so much about like, oh my goodness, my child has to be doing all these chores, but parents can feel like it's a huge, huge pull to get them to do basic hygiene and those household routines, maybe pack their lunch for school, things like that. So in this situation, there's no extracurricular, there's no real life friend time, they're not getting enough sleep, and all of that is being replaced by an excessive use of technology. So these are my clients typically. And so when parents reach out to me, they're expressing a lot of worry and concern, not just about the time that they're spending on technology or the lack of sleep they're getting, but oftentimes we see an increase in negative attitude, irritability, you know, snapping at parents. Maybe as parents are overhearing their kids use technology and playing games with their friends, we're hearing them use abusive language, racist language, just really interacting in a negative, angry way. Maybe we see more tantrums from these kids. Maybe they're competitive and easily frustrated when they don't, you know, win a game or get approval from their peers. So it's something that I want parents to recognize. Like, we want to shift from this type of pie to a more healthy. And it's not something that's going to happen overnight. I mean, your child didn't develop this schedule overnight. So it's okay to just work on easing some of these things. So maybe you might work at turning off technology earlier in the evening and making sure that kids are really treasuring and protecting the time that they can spend sleeping. You know, maybe you're making sure that if kids don't get their assignments done at school, that you make sure technology is turned off until those assignments are done. Maybe you restrict technology usage during the week and have kids sort of be bored into considering alternate activities. Usually when kids have limited access to technology, they want to find something else to do. And they may initially be very resistant. I can't find anything to do, I'm so bored. And they might come to parents and pester and negotiate and all of that. But, you know, with parents' gentle guidance and encouragement and giving them opportunities to participate in other things, they understand your choice is not between being bored and using technology. Your choice is between being bored and doing something that helps your pie look a little bit more balanced. So sometimes when parents do this carefully, mindfully, while educating their kids, and oftentimes they do it with someone like me, to have a third party who has the knowledge base to support their kids on developing new habits. Usually when someone like me gets involved, kids understand, like, mom and dad are taking this seriously. Like, we are going to change the patterns that are within our home. So I really encourage you, if you're a parent and you're really struggling with this and you need some guidance, go to my website, www.drtaraegan.com. Look at the coaching packages, because so many kids have benefited from getting support with their parents and working as a team when it comes to adjusting the balance in their life to more closely resemble this side than this side. Thanks for listening today.